Alright guys, it's part 3. Sorry about that guys, someone came in my room, I had to shut the camera off. Obviously, so because there's people in the house now, you might hear a bit of noise. But still, but my room is pretty soundproof. You don't hear much noise. Whenever people blast stuff upstairs, you don't hear much noise downstairs and down in my room. My room is pretty soundproof. It's pretty soundproof. So I'll talk for 30 minutes, and then my second part will be 23. My last part will be 23 minutes. See what I'm saying? Yeah, man. That's the amazing life me and Vijay are gonna live in. That's why Vijay will be shocked. Holy shit, Ivan. The world trolls our amazing glory, our bullshit sex over that amazing glory, yeah. Because you guys knew, yeah, if without I and Vijay be together, even though with seeing the eye glory is amazing, the two gods, they turn us on so much. We want to fuck them so bad. We're never going to know what it's like for these two gods to have sex. Yes, you let your envy take over. You see what I'm saying? You let your envy take over, obviously. Right? Right, yeah, even though you're gonna see our sex, now that me and Vijay are king and queen, you're now no longer a part of our glory. And you're not saved. That was the catch. The catch of seeing me and Vijay have sex, yeah, you see us, now you know what's like for me and Vijay to have sex, but now you're cut off from our glory. And you're not saved. Right? Whereas the catch was, if you let me and Vijay be together, yeah, you never know what's like for having sex, but being saved and seeing that glory every day makes up for the supposed price of seeing hell every night. You see what I'm saying? Now, seeing hell is not even a price to pay. You guys think it's a price, but it's not a price to pay. If seeing hell is only a price to pay if you're not saved. If you're saved, seeing hell is not a price. You're not paying a price. Because you're saved by the two gods every day. Seeing eye and image every day in the public eye and being saved makes up for seeing hell every night. You guys knew this. Yeah, yeah. Even though it pisses me off when everyone says, yeah, if we're saved, it's gonna make up for seeing hell. Yes. But you let your envy take over. You thought you can get your full cake world. Hence why you made this choice. You knew, yeah, I gave you that warning. I guarantee you guys, yeah. Ivan said something. Yeah, Ivan says, like, if we do this to Ivan, Ivan's going to peace out when he's king and his wife's queen with him. If we do this to an innocent man all because of our envy, when Ivan's king, he's going to peace out with his wife. When he's king and his wife's queen with him, he's going to peace out when we're king. And when he's king in glory, we're all left out of his glory. Yeah. I gave you the warning. If you do this to me, you're going to pay when I'm king also. And you still made the choice anyways. You guys are reprobate people, obviously. Because you somehow think there's hope that I'm going to save you when I'm king. No, man, I'm not saving you when I'm king. As right now, you don't even see my face. I already signed out on my channel, guys. Yeah, I'm pumping out a series for you, but it's a listening series. You don't see my face, guys. You see what I'm saying? I'm not making any videos for you ever on the Sabados channel. I'm going to keep saying that. You're not going to be saved. Yeah, man. In a couple minutes, guys, I'm gonna go get a coffee for myself. A nice, fresh cup of coffee. Yeah. Let's talk about the world tour. I'm gonna keep saying this. I'm going to keep on saying this. Okay, I am going to charge the venues for speaking as only if they charge the fans to come to the event, which they most likely will. They're obviously going to charge the fans. Okay, look, man, if you charge your fans, you charge the fans to come to the venue, I want a piece of that pie. It's fair. You charge the fans $10 to come hear me speak, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to charge you for speaking. Ivan, what's your starting price? My starting price range is like $25,000. But $25,000 is highly unlucky. On average, I'm going to charge about $50,000 plus. The chances are the venues that I'm going to be staying at, you're looking at 20,000 people on average around there. Okay, if there's 20,000 people, I want $55,000. $55,000, $60,000 to speak. You see what I'm saying? If I charge $60,000 to speak, me and Vijay can take 20 grand, and then 40,000 is split with the actors. They get like three. Me and Vijay can take like, I don't know, 17 grand. 18 grand if I get 60,000, and it's 42,000 split with the actors, and they make a nice like 3,000 each for themselves. You see what I'm saying? They make a nice like $2,700 check. 60,000 people, I'll take like 17,000, and I'll split like 43,000 with the actors. Me and Vita take the big chunk of the pie because we're the main show, obviously, but I'm going to give the actors a nice piece of the pie. So if there's 20,000 people, I'll charge like $55,000, $60,000 to speak. The people at the venue are going to make $200,000. They can easily afford to pay me $60,000. If there's 15, 10,000 people, I'll charge like 30, 35, 40, 45 grand around there to speak. 40 grand to speak. 40 grand, I'll take 10. The actors, the 29 grand, I'll take like 8 grand. And then the 22,000 split with the actors. If it's like 40 grand around there. You see what I'm saying here? If there's 30,000 people, I'm going to charge around 75,000. 80,000 to speak. If there's 30,000 people. That's a good deal, man. That's, if you charge all the 30,000 people 10 bucks, you're making like, what? You're making $300,000. You can easily afford to pay me $80,000 to speak. 75, 80K to speak. If I charge them $80,000 to speak, I'll take home 20 grand. Around there, 20 grand. 20 grand, 22 grand I'll take around there. And then the 48,000 split with the actors. They get like 4 grand each. So even though me and Vichy are taking a big chunk of the pie, I'm going to give the actors a good chunk of the pie too. A nice like 25, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000. If there's 40,000 people, I'm going to charge $100,000 plus. Because the moment you have 40,000 people, that's now a lot of people. Okay, if you have, how much people are you going to, how much fans are you going to have at the venue? Oh, no, I have 40,000 people. Okay, I want $100,000 for speaking at this huge venue for 40,000 people. If you charge the fans 10 bucks, you'll make your $400,000. You can easily afford to pay me my $100,000. They pay me $100,000, I'll take $30,000. Of the money, and then 70K split with the actors, and they make a good like 4 or 5 grand each around there, right? They make like 4 grand each, the actors. $4,200 each, the actors make. And me and Vijay take our 30,000. Even though I'm greedy, I'm generous, I'm still giving the actors a good chunk of the pie. So if I charge $100,000 for speaking at the venue, I will take care. I mean, how much care, Ivan? How do you want to split this? Okay, give me and VJ $30,000. Write me and VJ a $30,000 check. Don't write me and VJ two $15,000 checks. No, there's no point in doing that. Me and VJ are sharing the same account. Write me and VJ a $30,000 check for the, you know what I'm saying, and split the $70,000 with the actors and directors. They all get like 4 grand each, which is nice. When the actors had a check, Ivan, thank you, man. I appreciate that. Ivan's greedy, he took a good chunk of the pie. He's fucking generous. He gave us a nice chunk of the money, man. Yeah, I'm generous. I'm not cheap, man. I am greedy, obviously, but I'm not cheap. I'm willing to give a good chunk of the pie to the actors. You see what I'm saying? As most people, if this was someone else, they'd probably give the actors like 1,000 or something like that. They charge $100,000, they probably take like I don't know, 85,000 and they give 15,000 to the actors. Because we live in a greedy world. Whereas Ivan O'Meara, he takes $30,000 and he leaves $70,000 for the actors when he charges the venue $100,000 to speak. You see what I'm saying? If there's 50,000 people, I would charge about what? I would charge a good $130,000 to speak if there's 50,000 people. $150,000 to speak, I'll charge. Because the venue's going to make 500 grand, I want $150,000. You see what I'm saying? And anything over 60,000 plus is a lot of people. If there's 60,000 people, I'm going to charge around 170,000 to speak around there. 180,000 to speak. Close to that 200 range. And then 70,000, I'm going to charge 200,000 plus to speak. But I highly doubt they're going to have venues of 70, 80, 90. That's too much. The highest amount would probably be maybe 40,000 people at a venue around there. And for $40,000, I'll charge like $100,000 to speak at a venue, obviously. But most of the venues on average are probably going to be like 20,000 people around there. If it's 20,000 people, I'll only charge like 50,000, 55, 60,000 to speak, which is reasonable. The only people I won't charge are the churches. So the big ministries around the world, if they want to interview me and VJ, I won't charge them. Hey guys, we want to interview you and VJ. Okay, I'll speak at your church for free, but you have to provide the microphones and the tables for us. You see what I'm saying? For us to sit down, you know what I'm saying? If you want to play my trailer at your church, you have to provide your laptop and your projector and your HDMI. You have to provide all that. I'm not paying for you, obviously, but I won't charge the churches to speak. If the churches want to interview us, I'll speak for free. The churches are a non-profit organization. I won't charge the churches to speak. You don't charge churches to speak, I'm saying. Whereas the venues, I am charging them. Hey, if the church want to interview us, guys, let's speak for free at the church. Whereas the venues, we charge them. Charge them a nice, like, $50,000 on average for each speaking engagement. $50,000, $55,000, $60,000 to speak. Right? I'm going to tell the actor's agent, tell the actors to bring, to buy either an envelope, buy something to store all your checks in. I recommend you get a plastic zip bag. Every time you get your check, you just store the checks in your zip bag. Get like two big zip bags for yourself. You can store all your, like, I don't know, 60, 70 checks in there. All your nice checks, your nice $1,400, $2,500, $4,000, $10,000 checks. Yeah, man. Obviously. If I speak at a venue with like 50,000, 6,000 people and I charge $180K, the actors are going to make like $8,000 off that speaking, man. Off that speaking. Nice paycheck, man. Yeah. If there is something crazy with like, I don't know, like 70,000 fans, I charge $200K, I'll take home like $50,000 for myself. And then the $150,000 split with the actors. And the actors get like $9,000 each around there. Not else, $8,000 each. 16 people, 150 divided by 16 people, you're looking at like 9,000 each around there. 8,000 each around there, 7,000, 8,000 each to get the actors. Get about $9,000 each, the actors. Nice paycheck. Yeah. Give me a second, guys. I'm gonna get a cup of coffee, man. I need to get my fresh cup of coffee. Sorry about that, guys. Sorry for the wait. I went upstairs to get a fresh batch of coffee. Oh, a nice fresh coffee I had. My other coffee was old. I used the old coffee that also was gross. Yeah, man. So that's how much I'm going to charge the venues to speak. But I won't charge the churches. So if the big churches want to interview me, VJ, I'm more than happy to speak for free at your church. You want to invite me over to speak at this church, I will speak for free. I won't charge you guys. You know what I'm saying? But you guys have to cover all the expenses for the what? With the tables, the chairs. You have to provide the tables, the chairs, the microphones for me to speak, obviously. You have to, and if you want to play my trailers at your church, you need to what? You're going to need a projector. You're going to need your laptop. You have to provide all that. You see what I'm saying? Whereas the venues, I am not speaking for free if they charge the fans. I'm going to charge them. You see what I'm saying? The actors are going to make a nice, like, I don't know, $200K off speaking fees. Because all the places on average, the actors are going to be making a couple $1,000s for themselves. A nice $2,500 around there for themselves, yeah. I don't know, I speak a venue for 20,000 people, I charge $60,000. Me and Vici take home like 18,000-17,000, and like the actors take home like $2,000, $2,200 the actors take home. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, imagine making $2,000 for like 70 places. You just made like 140K for yourself. But chances are there's going to be some venues where there'll be like 50,000 people. Hence what? Hence if there's 50,000 people, I'll be charging like 100,000. And 100,000, the actors are making like $4,000, $5,000 each for the venue. Yeah, they're going to make probably a good like $150,000 to $180,000, $200,000 the actors for the world tour. And me and Vijay will make like $700,000, $800,000, $900,000 in speaking fees. We're going to make a lot of money, man. A lot of money. We're going to make a lot of money, guys. A lot of money, man. Yeah, the internet's now reconnected so I can upload the video. Because my stepfamily came back home and then they reconnected the internet so I can upload the video now, guys. You don't have to worry. You don't have to panic. You don't have to be mad. And I'm saying, oh, what if I just upload the video? Yeah, I'll upload the video today. Obviously. Because if I don't charge the venues, Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni and Vijay will be like, Ivan, we're being too nice. These people are benefiting off our success. Yeah, you're benefiting off our success for our Last of Us movie. It's fair that we get a piece of the pie. The only way I will charge the venues is if they don't charge it. If you don't charge the fans, I won't charge you. I'll speak for free. I'm more than happy to speak for free if you don't charge the fans. But they are going to charge the fans. Hence why what? I'm gonna charge them a fee. Look, man, if you're charging all the fans who are coming to see me speak, I want a piece of the pie. I deserve a piece. Yeah, I mean, it's fair. Yes. If you know what I'm saying? The more fans you have, the higher what? The higher amount, the more I charge. So I'm saying, if you have a venue of like 50,000 people, I'm going to charge 100,000 plus. 100, 125K around there to speak, I'm going to charge. You see what I'm saying? Which is reasonable. If you charge all the fans $10... and you make $500,000, you can easily afford to pay me $100,000, $125,000. You see what I'm saying? You're saying yes. Hence why what? That's my starting price range is $25K to speak. But $25K is highly unlucky. The only way I'll ever charge $25K is if there's only like 5,000 people. If it's a small venue of like 500, if it's a small venue of like 5,000 people, I would charge $25K. Obviously, but if chances are it will be like a good like 20,000 people, I'll charge on average 60,000 to speak. You see what I'm saying? And the money split with the actors and all of them, obviously. I'm gonna tell the actors, guys, make sure you take good care of your checks. I recommend you guys buy a plastic zip bag, or you get an envelope. A big envelope. You know those big envelopes? Get a big one. You can store all your checks in your envelope. I recommend you get the zip bag. The zip bag is easier. You just take, you open the zip bag, you put your checks in the zip bag, and you zip your bag, and you put it in a safe place in your luggage. Don't leave your checks out outside the jet. No, someone can steal it. When you're done, put it in your luggage. That way no one takes it. See what I'm saying? Put it in your luggage where no one can see it. Otherwise, people can steal your check. We live in a wicked world, man. People can steal your check, man. See what I'm saying? Because there's nothing worse than the actors, you know what I'm saying, the world tour ends and they count all the checks. Yeah, how much places we visited, Ivan? Yeah, we visited a good 70 places. Now, Ivan, I only have 65 checks and like 5 of your checks are missing. Yeah, someone stole your checks and if you lose your checks, they're not going to recompensate us. Hey guys, if you lose your checks, you will not be recompensated. Hence why take good care of your checks. Buy a zip bag and what? Yeah. I'm going to tell the... Yeah. When the actors check in the hotel, they'll be checking in with their luggage. Obviously. They'll be checking in with their luggage, obviously. So I don't have to worry about the people at the airport stealing our checks in the plane. Because whenever we exit the plane, all the actors are going to bring their luggage with them. Their luggage with them, obviously. The actors only need to bring one luggage for the world tour. One, two luggages is enough. Because they're going to have to bring their clothes. their underwear, their boxers, all that stuff. They have to bring all that. That's what. Yeah. Hotels have laundry machines, but you have to pay for the laundry. I can even have John Favreau and Nick Filoni find a laundry company to wash our clothes. We're gonna need a place to. The hotels have washing machines to wash the actors' clothes. Me and Vijay can cover that. We can cover the cost for the actors. Okay, whenever you guys want to wash clothes in the hotel, it's all covered through the business account. See what I'm saying? If you want to wash your clothes in a hotel, obviously, because hotels have laundry machines too, but they charge you for it. I think, or it's free. I think it's free. I remember using the laundry before in a hotel. It's free. If you book the hotel, you get free laundry. You see what I'm saying? But we're only going to be staying at the places for a day. But the actors are going to have to wash their clothes when we travel to all these places, obviously. After a good week or so, your boxers will start to stink. You see what I'm saying? Your shirts will start to stink. Hence why you need to wash it. You need to wash your clothes, obviously, right? Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Obviously. You're gonna see the actors, they have like 70 checks in their zip bags. Holy shit, I'm fucking rich. You're gonna see VJ Ivan, look at how much money we have. Oh my god, Ivan, we made like a lot of money off our merch. But now we're also making a lot of money off the speaking fees. We made like 800K off speaking, Ivan. You're gonna see VJ all excited, yeah. Holy shit, Ivan, we're so rich. Hey, VJ, we're going to have to cash all these checks. Me and VJ can either cash the checks in the machine. If we do that, the bank will freeze our checks, obviously. Or we can take a picture of our checks. If you do that, the bank freezes your account for 5 days. Or we can cash all 70 checks at the bank. I don't know, you see me and VJ, we walk to the bank. we have our like zip bag. Okay, we want to cash 70 checks. And the bank's like, what? You want to cash how much checks? 70 checks. Oh my god, we're gonna be here for a good hour. It's gonna take a good hour just to cash all these 70 checks. You know what I'm saying? We cash all the 70 checks, yeah. At the bank. What I'll do is, okay, VJ, let's cash like 10 checks at a time. No, Ivan, or we can just cash the whole thing, that we get it over with. And then you're gonna see all the people at the bank giving me VJ dirty ass stares. Look at Ivan, VJ, they're fucking rich. They made like 800K off their speaking fees. And we're all making like 50, 60, 100K a year. 200K a year. And Ivan made like $800,000 off his speaking fees. And he made a lot of money off his merch. You can see people giving us dirty looks. Yeah, it's actually funny. But giving the actors dirty looks when the actors cast their checks. You know what I'm saying? Because the actors all got, they made like 200K off speaking, man. Yeah, a lot of money, man. I don't know if the agents take 10% of the actors' cut for the speaking fees. I'm gonna tell the actors, look, man, the speaking fees is not a part of the contract. Because I don't know for sure if I'm going to go on that world tour. That's why I'm not going to have the actors sign that contract for the speaking fees. The speaking fees is not a part of the contract. Because I don't know if the agent takes 10% of the actors. I don't think they do. But in Hollywood, how it works is the agent takes 10% of everything you make, man. Even your speaking fees, I believe. Even for speaking fees, the agent takes 10%. The actors might be a bit pissed off about that. I don't want to give the agent 10% of my earnings, but chances are the agent might want a piece of that. But yeah, I want a piece of that. I want 10% of your earnings. You made 200K. I want a nice $20,000 worth of that. The agent might want a piece of that. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, the agent might want a piece of that. That's why what? Hence why you have to be what? You have to be careful. You have to be careful. You see what I'm saying? You have to be careful. The actors have to be careful, obviously. I'm gonna tell the actors, look, man. You're gonna have to settle this with your agent, man. It's none of my business, man. If your agent wants 10%, that's your problem, man. You're gonna have to settle this with your agent. The chances are the agents might want a piece of that pie. Yeah, I want a nice 10% of that. The speaking fees, yeah. They want 10% of everything the actor makes. The agent is taking 10% of everything the actor makes for the movie project. His salary, his or her salary earnings, their commercial money earnings are $60,000. The agent takes a nice like $6,000 worth of that. Yeah, man. The agent also takes 10% of what the actor's commercial earnings too. Yeah, the $60K they made, the agent takes 10% of that. Yeah, the agent also takes 10% of the merch, the $250,000 merch royalty. They take 10% of that too. Yeah, $250,000 after taxes is like one. $250,000 in American money is like $200K in Canadian money. $250K in Canadian money is like $200K in like American money. And see, after taxes, it's like 120. The agent takes 10% of that. And see, actors are walking away with like a $105,000 check. $190,000 check. Just depends where you live after taxes and the rates. It's a nice paycheck, man. So you not only got your nice royalty check, you also got your nice what? Your nice speaking fee money. The money the actors made off their speaking fees for the world tour. They made a lot of money, yeah, man. That's why the holy shit, man. Ivan blessed us, man. Ivan's company blows hot out of the water, man. I made like 200 grand off speaking. Speaking. Yeah. $200,000 is a lot of money for speaking fees, man. That's a lot of money. For the actors, I'm saying, as most of the world's best speakers around the world, all these big professors around the world who speak, they don't even make that kind of money for speaking fees. They make like, they probably get like $5,000 for speaking around there, $7,000 for speaking. You see what I'm saying here? $7,000 for speaking, yeah. And I and VJ made a shitload of money off their speaking fees for the Last of Us Ants movie. You see what I'm saying? Yeah, they made a lot of money. Yeah, man. Yeah, man. Something crazy. I made a lot of money, man. I made a lot of money off what? Off the speaking fees, obviously. That's why the actors are going to beg their asses off. Fuck, Ivan, I just want to work for you, man. Your company is so much better than Hollywood, man. I had a fun time going on that world tour, making all that money. Making that nice, like, $200,000, $180,000 I made. Fuck, man, your company is so much better than Hollywood. I just want to work for you, and Hollywood's fucking cheap. I don't get shit for the world tours. You know what I'm saying? I don't make any money for touring. Hollywood has to stay in shittier standard hotels for the tours around America and all that stuff. Whereas you, Ivan, you had to stay in luxury hotels. You gave us a buffet feeding for eating, and you... You paid us a lot of money. You were nice enough, Ivan, to give us a lot of money for the speaking. Yeah. Now, even though Ivan's greedy, yeah, Ivan took the majority of the pie, took a big chunk of the pie, but they gave us a nice chunk of the pie too. Ivan was nice enough to give us a nice chunk of the pie. He's not cheap. Now, even though Ivan's greedy, he's not cheap, man. He's generous. He gave us a good chunk of the pie for the speaking fees. Yeah, man. You got your nice $2,000. $1,400, $3,000, $4,000. Yeah, man, it's nice, man, for speaking. It's a nice paycheck for speaking. For 2.5 hours, you get like $4,000. $2,000 is a nice paycheck, man. You see what I'm saying? I'm going to take the majority of the pie because me and Vijay are the main show, obviously, but I'm nice enough to give the actors a good chunk of the pie for speaking. You see what I'm saying? A good chunk of the pie for speaking. End this part here in about a minute. Obviously. You see what I'm saying here? Obviously you're saying yes. Yeah. That's the amazing life me and Vijay are going to live. You see what I'm saying here? That's the amazing life me and Vijay are going to live. You see what I'm saying here? Yeah, man. Because my Sky Source company is better than Hollywood. And you guys already know how good my company is. You'll see, you can see the future. I have the keys. Yeah, if we know how top-notch your company will be, yeah, you're looking at a top-notch company of my own, man. Show me a kind of here.